Hiraeth. It's a Welsh word that describes homesickness. Longing for a home to which you cannot return. A home which maybe never was. The nostalgia. The yearning. The grief for the lost places of your past. It's an immaculate definition for homesickness, if I say so myself. Everyone encounters homesickness at some point in their life. It's either from moving to a new house, moving to a different continent, or moving out from your parents to a big city, or simply just growing up. All those wistful retinues trigger a sense of longingness in us, that everything was so much better back then. In today's video, I'll delve into an uncharted sentiment of ours that we never seem to grasp, and hopefully, by the end of the video, we can finally fathom an emotion which maybe never was. To understand homesickness, we must first define home. So, what is a home? Well, a home commonly refers to a place where one lives with a family. Then again, what is a family? Family is such a broad spectrum of meaning. It can either define as someone genetically related to you, or simply is someone that you love. Family can transcend all barriers, as long as you feel that tenacious, infrangible affection. It could be either your mother, your stepfather, a friend, or even a place. So, by definition, the poised feeling of being home is when you are surrounded by an ardour of affinity, ordinaire, belonging, love, and reposing smile. And when those feelings are stripped away, that is when you experience homesickness, a loss that is inevitable, yet we cradle it for our dear lives. Reminiscent dreams keeps you lulling during the day, and a mirage of deja vu laughters keep you awake in the middle of the night. Whenever the moment is, those memories that you once thought was your reality is now buried within your consciousness, but growing stronger day by day, until you accept your newfound reality, your present reality. Until then, your mind will always flutter to the past, when you laughed so hard with your friends that you accidentally snorted, or the tears you shed from falling off a bike before you triumphantly cycled a lap around your garden, or when you first feasted your eyes on snow, or when you got an F on your test but eventually got the A you thrived for. Whichever good or bad it was, when you looked back, you knew you had a time of your lives, that whatever happened then, that you turned out just okay, that you walked out from that storming sea or the sunniest of days and came out meeting new people, experiencing new emotions, traveled to multiple countries, and tales to tell of such an extraordinary journey. And then it hits. All those time, those nostalgias, that longingness, the lessons you learned, the experiences you had, the tears you shed, you took it all for granted. And what comes out of it is regret. A scar that embeds in your soul in the form of this convoluted emotions, which you are very much familiar with, homesickness. And that's what homesickness means to me. Regretting that you never appreciated the present, that you were never grateful to live in the moment. Maybe you should have laughed more from that awful joke from your friend. Or maybe you should have stopped looking at the phone when you should have indulged yourself with a breezing street. Or initiated the conversation with that one person in school. Or spent more time with the family at home. Or just smiled in the face of all odds. I made this channel last year during the lockdown, when the world was spiraled into a bleak place, when the world we lived in came to a temporary halt. The world was in a standstill, and so was I. The flying voices of responsibilities and flashing images of this world dissipated for a moment. And during that limbo of a moment, my consciousness came into one, salvaging all the buried emotions that I've locked away since I've moved away from the place. The place I thought was home, to now a country that's bustling with divergence. I came to the conclusion that I was experiencing homesickness. At first, I didn't want to accept it, because the term homesick is so mainstream. But then I've realized that I checked every box there was to legitimize myself as someone that is suffering it. And I've come to an understanding, maybe everything is juxtaposed to what it really is. Maybe this was the remedy for my homesickness. That, if you can't return to your home, maybe it never was your home. And maybe the lost places of your past were never lost to begin with. Maybe the true definition of home has always been you. And maybe homesickness has always been the longingness of who you were before, the emotions you felt, the experiences you experienced. Maybe you are the one that is lost, muddled by your weaving emotions. Maybe to return home, you need to invent a new home, a larger one, a better one, and an exuberant one compared to the last. My advice to myself and anyone else that feels the same way is to simply go out there, step into that storm of to-be memories. Nevertheless, how terrifying it will be, no matter how feeble you will be. Because if you never took that first step before, you'd never have the memories that you cherish so much. So go out there, make new memories, new friends, travel to new countries, and even find new love. No matter the rejection, no matter the fall, no matter the tears. Because at the end of the day, when your future self looks back to now, you will realize that whatever happens, you will turn out just fine. As one of my favorite authors, Dr. Seuss, once said, "Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened." As always, thanks for watching. This video took me ages to make since homesickness is a topic that means a lot to me. If you have time to subscribe and like the video, that would be greatly appreciated. And for the final time, Diolch yn fawr iawn.